Hello, Saddleback family, and welcome to December. Here we are in this very strange, very different year, still celebrating the birth of Jesus. And the birth of Jesus is just as powerful this year. The presence of Jesus is just as powerful this year. Things are different, but His love for you has never changed. And that's what we get to remind ourselves of during this Christmas season together, this celebration of His birth. I was reminded of a part of the story, the Christmas story, in my devotional reading in John a couple days ago. Let me go back to the part of the Christmas story first and then read from the book of John. In Luke chapter 2, the Bible tells us this, verse 6, while they, Mary and Joseph, were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. And she wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them available in the inn. I have often thought about that poor innkeeper who couldn't find a room for Mary and Joseph. She didn't know that the Savior of the world was going to be born that night, but they missed an opportunity to have the Savior of the world be born in their inn. And I have to admit that at times I've been a little judgmental against that innkeeper, that maybe if they'd had a better spiritual sensitivity, if they'd listened to God more, they would have known what was happening. They would have responded in the right way. But then I was reading in the book of John this week, Jesus is having a talk with some people who, they believed what he said, but they hadn't trusted yet in who he was. They were people who thought Jesus was the Son of God, but they hadn't decided yet to follow him as the Son of God. And he talks about the fact that actually they want to push him away. And as he's talking about that in the book of John, he has this to say to them. And it just spoke to me. I think maybe it'll speak to you. He talks to them about them wanting to push him away. And he says, the reason you're doing this is because, this is John verse 8, verse 37. You're looking for a way to kill me, because you have no room for my word. Wow. They couldn't make room for God's word in their life. And because of that, they had to push Jesus out of their life. It was convicting to me because I thought of the times when I haven't made room for God's word in my life. And I've talked to you many times at Christmas about the fact that we have a hard time making room for God, for Jesus, for Christmas, because of the busyness of the season. This year, it may be more the messiness of the season. The fact that things aren't the same. The fact that things aren't as you hoped. And in all of that, we can get caught up in missing the truth of this season. God loves you. Jesus came to bring you salvation. God's presence is with us, Emmanuel. Now, the truth is, if there's going to be room for God's word in my heart, it's not going to happen by accident. I think we all know that. To have room for God's word in my heart, I have to make room for God's room in my heart. So instead of looking at that old innkeeper judgmentally this year, I'd like to a little bit more look at my own heart and say, Jesus, how can I not get caught up in the messiness and the busyness and the differentness of this season? And instead of that, make sure I get caught up in the truth of this season, your word for this season, the word of God made flesh. You have come into this world to give us life. And the truth that will never change is the truth of God's presence with you, the truth of God's love for you, the truth of God's grace toward you, the truth of God's forgiveness poured out on you. So whatever happens, whatever the circumstances, and I know they're tough for some of us, whatever the circumstances, those truths do not change. Let's hang on to that together this Christmas season. Let's celebrate Jesus together this Christmas season. Would you pray with me? Father, thank you for our Saddleback family. And thank you for the many Christmas seasons for some of us that we've celebrated together. For some of us, this is the first we've celebrated with this new family. Wherever we are, Lord, in that, I pray that this would be a season of looking to you. This would be a season of making room for you in our hearts, room for your word in our thoughts. Jesus, we don't want to go through this season missing the truth of who you are, the greatness of your love for us, and the grace that you will pour out on us. And so we rest in that together right now. We praise you in your name. Amen. Amen. Well, Merry Christmas, everybody, and I love you all.